All right, so new thing for the new podcast.
New name, first of all.
New name, which we haven't discussed yet. Oh, no, we have. Yes, Defecast.
Defecast.
Welcome to Defecast.
Oh,
well, me and Michael.
Me and Michael.
Oh, I see.
Sorry,
guys. It's news for me, too.
No, it's because... Well, what was it? Like, if we...
There were little roadblocks with the whole iTunes thing.
We can't...
Yeah, iTunes. Yeah,
we won't be able to upload it with shit in it.
Yeah, even if you censor it.
Oh,
yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
So what were you saying? You, like, put a star with it?
Yeah, even that wouldn't work.
Yeah, so... Yeah, so we come up with Defecast. Which, yeah, basically the
essentially
same thing.
Yeah,
I like it.
Defecate ourselves.
Glad I agreed.
Live.
Because that would have been awkward.
Recorded.
If we had, like, a massive argument.
Massive fucking argument, yeah.
Oh, what's the name? We don't give a fuck about you, Dave. Oh, thanks.
You're just here for content. Shut up.
Just because I do voices. Which I haven't done yet.
Well, yeah.
I think you just need to be glad that I'm a brilliant fucking wordsmith and came up with it.
Shut up. I came up with shitcast. That's good.
Yeah, you're halfway there.
It got really quiet there.
Yeah, so basically, three of us get together and we watch a movie. One of us picks a movie without telling the other two what that movie is. Now, it should be pretty valid to point out that it doesn't have to be a shit movie.
Yes.
Because we didn't point it out to the person that chose the first movie this week, which was...
No, I knew it didn't have to be a shit movie. I know that if we were looking through movies and I said, oh, we should watch this, it's a movie from my childhood, you'd look at it and go, oh, fuck, you know this, I'm not watching that.
No, but I just know it's going to be bad. Like, it's from his childhood. Yeah. It should be pretty...
And pretty much everything from his childhood
anybody
is bad.
Anybody who doesn't know us, Dave is 9 years older than us.
It's an 80s fucking movie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This better be the fucking Goonies.
I still love it.
Not even the Goonies. I don't think I could watch that.
I could sit through it.
Alright, so anyway.
So, I was actually thinking we make a point of making them
we
somewhat...
Fucking, can we introduce ourselves first?
Oh, yeah, sorry.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Oh,
maybe
Dave.
Dave?
You're Dave as well,
yeah,
huh?
I'm Dave too.
Oh, alright.
Yeah.
I'm Carl then, fuck you.
You're not good looking enough to be me.
Alright, Carl Fernando, group for our first Defecast. No, you don't have to.
Oh, because the women are going to think I'm stupid.
Bonniches.
Oh, there he goes.
Yeah.
Alright.
Well, I'm going to be fucking plugging this through Facebook anyway.
I'm just going to call myself Davey Boy.
Yeah, Davey Boy. Yeah.
You and your fucking Facebook.
Davey Boy, Carl Fernando, and
Michael.
Here for the Defecast Volume 2.
Call me whatever you want, Sunshine.
Shitcast Volume 2. Defecast.
Defecast, yeah.
Defecast.
The reboot.
Like that. Well done.
Talking
well
to myself here.
No, you're not. People are listening.
Yeah.
Just not us.
Yeah. That's what I fucking tell myself to make myself feel better.
Yeah. The two biggest audience members.
Oh, God.
All right, so, yeah.
Well, I've been hanging for this, like, the whole week. It's been bugging me.
To find out
what the fuck we're watching. So Dave...
Basically, we got Dave to pick the first movie, which was a big mistake.
Yeah, pretty
much. I said that when I asked you. I said, are you sure you want to do that?
But you know what?
Defecast might be a bit DOA, I think.
The mental strategy that I had, I was like, I know Dave's going to pick a shit fucking movie.
So I'm going to go up from there.
No, get it out the way first.
Oh, yeah.
Get it out the way. It's like a Band-Aid. Yeah. Peel it off quick.
That's just rude.
Hey, Dave.
Yeah, why did that was so Bill Burr? I got it out of the way.
What it was, dude. Didn't have the Boston accent. Alright,
nah,
so.
But seriously, yeah, fuck yourself.
Alright, so let's find out because me and Michael have been dying.
Alright, so before I announce it,
all week,
do we.
Oh,
I just want to talk about the
set some ground rules.
The format?
Well, not ground rules, but. Do we make a point of trying to make it somewhat bad? So we're not sitting here judging box office movies?
No. Like, I think the way I looked at it was like, there's I know there's some movies that Michael hasn't watched that I'm like, I think he'd really enjoy. Right. And I'm like, oh,
that's a fit one.
Yeah, and yeah, I'm like, that I really enjoy. And I'm like, I know he's never
going to... Probably a way of getting us to sit down.
That's and right. Shit. Yeah, he's never going to watch it on his own.
Yeah.
Kind of like some things that I've given him that he's had for 2 years.
X-Files.
Yeah.
I don't care for
horror flash. I don't care for horror
flash. Yeah, basically, I was going to use this as a platform to make you guys watch shit I've been trying to get you to watch your fucking years. Yeah. So.
Awesome.
Yeah, pretty
well, much. Well, I've already taken advantage of that.
Yeah, so that's the basic idea. And it can be shit movies. It can be, you know, it can be anything you want.
Yeah.
Pretty much. So, let's hear it. What's the first movie?
All right. I don't think it's a shit movie.
Yeah.
I don't think it's a great movie by today's
standards. Let me sit up.
No, strapped in. I reckon Marshman's probably not even heard of it. Krull.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
I knew Carl was going to react like that because I asked him to watch it like years ago.
Dude, just look at the cover and you're like, why? Not, no. Why? Yeah. Why did you watch that? Fuck.
Well, like I said.
I will say the name sounds familiar. I don't think I've seen anything of it.
Yeah.
I remember seeing this at the fucking video store and...
People were pissing on it?
No. The video store had obviously sections, genres, just like Blockbuster.
Yeah.
Like, you had sections. All the shit ones were next to the wrestling section. That's the only reason I remember it. Because I'd go fucking rent WrestleMania.
Oh, so you were in the shit section.
No, right? I'd walk past it. And it was past the adult section too. So...
I was implying that wrestling was the shit section.
Nah. Better than fucking Crawl, that's for sure. Can you give us some background information? Okay. Can you set it up for us?
Right. It's a sci-fi. It's an 80s sci-fi.
As if the name didn't give it away.
It's an 80s sci-fi.
When was it made?
A world called Krull.
The early 80s?
K-R-U-L-L.
Mid or late?
I think it's early 80s. Mid to late 80s, maybe.
We got fucking...
86 and green and velvet, I might be wrong.
Oh, holy shit, they remade it, dude. 2001.
Nah.
Yeah, I'm fucking looking at iTunes.
Holy shit, we're watching that the next time I get a picture.
What the fuck?
Crawl fucking twice.
July 29th, 1983.
83. Right. So it's just before the peak of the 80s.
Holy fuck, it's got goddamn Liam Cock Neeson in it.
Yeah, it's got Liam Neeson. It's got a few big actors. Oh, not big actors, but actually some of the side actors, like the actors and actresses that didn't play main roles went on to be like Liam Neeson. Liam Neeson went on to be Liam Neeson. No. And there's another guy, I'll tell you once you've seen him. He plays like, I've seen him in different things. Like, I think he was in The Mummy as a guy.
Like the new Mummy? Like the one
The Mummy Returns or something.
Oh, yeah. With fucking Rachel Wise?
Rachel
Wise. That's how you pronounce the name, Wise.
Really?
Wise. Yeah.
I always thought it was Vice.
Yeah.
Wise.
Yeah.
Is that how she pronounces
it? No, I heard...
Well, then you don't know shit. Until she says it, you don't know. Right?
Back on track with this shit movie.
Oh, mate. We're going to come back and you're going to be all like, oh my God, that was the best. I'm so sorry.
All right, can you tell us the plot of it?
All right, so Krull is the name of the world and it's being invaded by... the Beast and his army of minions called the Slayers, and essentially it's basically all about how they...
So it's an alien world getting invaded?
Yeah.
Invaded?
Yeah.
So it's not like a fucking futuristic Earth or anything like
No.
So it's not even entertaining. It was for fucking 7 year old Dave.
No. Look, it's dated, but no. I think it has potential to be entertaining.
This totally explains how you got into World of Warcraft.
Really?
Yeah. Cause like,
if I told you how I got into World of Warcraft,
everything else about you does not scream World of Warcraft to me. But the fact that you love this show or TV, movie, whatever the fuck it is.
Right. As a kid. I haven't played World of Warcraft for 2 years. It looks
like a TV movie. It looks like a TV movie.
Actually, I only got into World of Warcraft because I was playing StarCraft. And then I went from Starcraft, and the people I was playing Starcraft with got me into Diablo, and then they got me into World of Warcraft. But anyway, it's got nothing to do with me being a massive fucking nerd who's into old shitty sci-fi movies. No, because generally I didn't like sci-fi movies as a kid, but he's got this weapon. It's called the glaive.
It's called Liam Neeson's cock.
The glaive. It's like this, I think it's like this five-sided star blade thing, and you can throw it and you can control it.
Yeah.
And it's like spins and makes this.
Sort of the boomerang.
Yeah. It's a boomerang.
Fuck. Alright, so now we gotta watch this thing, and then we're gonna come back and we're hopefully
gonna apologize for being so rude.
I just already know what we're in for, because I remember you showing me fucking screenshots.
Nah, you come in and saw me watching it.
Oh, that's long. Right, yeah. And it was up to that spider part. Oh, fuck me. That was so bad.
It was stop motion. It's like watching the Terminator again.
No.
It is.
No, it wasn't.
Terminator stop motion.
Yeah, you can't. Who directed it? You can't compare Terminator to that.
No, but I'm talking about you come in and watch the spider part.
It feels like fucking Labyrinth.
What? You didn't get anything. Labyrinth was a good movie too.
Not from what I remember.
I love Labyrinth.
Fuck. Hey, we're going to watch that at some point too, aren't we?
Nah.
I don't plan on it.
Fuck.
I'm not sure I get you to watch things that you haven't watched.
Yeah, well, it can be anything. Like, even if we've watched it. Because
you'll have some ground to say.
Well, we're going to watch. Dave's already watched it. Damn it, it's not here. That's all right. All right, so we've got to watch Kroll. All right, so we'll watch Kroll, and then we'll
come back more dejected than we already are.
Hopefully be awake. And watch it.
Mate, you used to deliberately go to a weekly screening of absolutely shithouse and D-grade movies.
Hey, I was against that for a while, so I'm like, I don't want to watch shit movies. I'm like, can we watch fucking at least just throw in a good movie every second week just to keep us doing it? Yeah. And
well, there happened? You go. And what now happened? You can pick the good movie.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. I'm getting what I want. Alright, so let's go watch this, and then to anyone listening, it'll be like we're gone for a second, because I'll just cut it in. Yeah, so let's go and watch this thing.
Alright. Shut up.
Alright.
Well, I'm glad. And I'm glad it's not my turn.
We're back after watching Kroll.
Yeah, and I'm glad it's no longer my turn. It's over for the next two movies. You cynical fucking assets.
Judging by Dave's reaction there, you can tell what we thought of it.
But you stayed silent through at least the first
20 minutes?
No.
Half an hour?
You guys were quiet through like the first good.
No,
a good 40 minutes of it.
I was still gauging it. I was like,
"Yeah,
what is this?" I mean, it's not as bad as I thought it would be, but my God,
yeah,
it's dated. But it's
dated. I think that's the big problem with it.
But I think, look, there are a lot of plot holes in it.
Yeah,
but like, I think there are a lot of good ideas as well.
Yeah, like what you started saying is that the story itself is like pretty, that's what gets you, is what's intriguing. Yeah. But
there's just problems with the execution.
Yeah. Would you say it's the acting, like the overacting?
I think the whole guy overacts it. Like he's a lot. Like,
well,
Marshman picked it first. He's like,
Let's just go through it again now that we've watched it. So, you've got the main character, which is the prince Colwyn, who turned into the king because there's... Alright, so there's an alien invasion on this one planet called Kroll, and there's two kingdoms on this planet, supposedly, and they make peace to fight the alien invasion. And the way they make peace is to wed their two, marry their kids. So one fucking one kingdom's got a daughter, the other kingdom's got a prince. And the princess gets kidnapped by the alien, the head alien. What the fuck? What's his name?
The Beast.
The Beast. That's his name, the Beast. Fuck. They couldn't have come up with something better? Like, well, just giving him some sort of a name? Sake. The Beast.
They saw Liam Neeson's dick and they're like, well,
oh, fuck. Yeah,
that's what we got to name it.
Yeah. And then...
No shortage of those jokes while we're watching the movie, by the way.
I just think... Yeah, alright. It, look, I knew picking this movie that you guys were gonna like. That's part of the fun.
I mean, it wasn't from lack of trying.
No. I glanced over and you were asleep a couple of times, but you know.
I was nodding off. I didn't quite fall asleep. I was trying to stay awake. Yeah.
But granted, you and Carl gave it a decent effort. The fact that you guys weren't commenting through the first 40 minutes of it was somewhat of, I don't know.
What, did that scare you, or?
Nah, well, I just kept thinking you guys were sleeping.
No, I was actually, my thought pattern was like, I really do want to give this a go, like, really want to try to immerse myself in it, but... Yeah, it got to a point where I'm like, oh, no, I just couldn't do it. Like, I think...
The soundtrack stopped doing it for you.
Yeah, well, the soundtrack initially is what I liked about it, because, like, it opens over the credits with the alien ship landing on Krull coming from outer space, but it reminded me of Aliens and the soundtrack to Aliens. Like, Alien, the first one. And then the more it got into it, it kind of had elements of the Never-Ending Story and Star Wars in it. But
I thought the sword fight scenes were very sort of Star Wars-ish.
In the way they choreographed.
Those laser guns.
Yeah. The red and blue laser guns. Mm. Yeah, definitely. But like when they're going through that... they just, that first journey that they have, like the king and the old man, and it's like, we need to find the blind dude because he'll tell us where the fucking place is, and then they find the blind dude and then he's no help. He's like, you need to go here to find it, and then they're on the way to wherever the fuck it was to find it, and then in that time the old dude gets taken over by the Beast. So he gets killed by the Beast, then gets replaced with a replica of him who tries to kill the king, and then they're like, we need to go find the fucking Black Widow. Or the Widow of the fucking Web.
Yeah.
And
but that was
even my, she's no help.
That was my interpretation of their idea of some sort of plot fuck up.
There was a fucking there was a goddamn Cyclops in it, and dude, honestly, he felt like he was the hero of the story.
Mm.
Like, he saved the king three times.
Well, he was, really.
Yeah, three times he saved the king. And it's like, how the fuck?
It's meant to be creepy, but cool.
Yeah, well, it was definitely creepy. And he was, and obviously the guy acting in it couldn't see behind the fucking outside of the face mask.
Yeah.
Because he couldn't... Didn't know.
There were moments there where he's like trying to shake hands or throwing the spear, and he didn't look so comfortable.
Even just when there was a shot of him, like he was facing sort of towards the camera, and then he turned to move, and he just moved his whole body like that.
Yeah.
And I was just like, that's so fucking weird, man.
Yeah. Yeah, it's that, like, he had no eye line. You could see when he was talking to people. He obviously had to be looking down at him because he's supposed to be so much bigger than him, but he just wasn't.
Yeah.
And he was looking almost over the top of their heads. And then, like,
but to me, that's poor directing. Because the director should be like, hey, arch your back a bit, dude. you're not making proper eye contact.
Proper eye lines, yeah.
Yeah. So fucking bend over. Let's do this again. Alright, cut.
Yeah, true. But then too, that's like makeup as well. Like, surely they could have made the makeup a little bit better where he could see through it. I found his
makeup. Oh yeah, yeah. No, I get the whole see through it thing. But then you wonder if they put holes in it to make him able to see. Are you as the viewer going to pick that up and go, oh, look, there's fucking holes in his eye?
I think
they tried to make it as authentic. Like, for the time, I think they tried to make it as authentic as possible.
Well, when was it made? 1983. Yeah.
I think all that time. Like, even the time when he went to shake Colwyn's hand or whatever, whoever his hand.
Colwyn. Colwyn.
He was shaking someone's hand. It was like you missed. There was like a section. There was like a brief where he went. He reached out and missed, and then it was ever so subtle.
Mm.
And obviously, the director thought, "Ah, oh, fuck it, let's go on to the next scene."
You know what? That was shot in 1983. They don't have the playback that we have now.
Yeah, but they don't have eyes. Like, watching that.
Live, yeah, but when
you'd be able to see that and go, that didn't look quite right, dude.
Well, keep in mind that could have been like the 20th take, and they could have been running out of time as well.
Yeah,
I could have tried it so many times and just.
And I can close my eyes right now, and say, all right, put your hand here.
No.
Put your hand there. No, I'll grab it. Did that look authentic?
Yeah.
All right.
I was just watching your hands.
Yeah, but. I got it first grab.
Yeah.
That's my point.
Yeah.
I closed my eyes and I got it first grab. So, I can't see how that would take.
Yeah, I see what you're saying. I see what you're saying. Like, look, just put your fucking hand here. Or even to eliminate it, you can say.
Have him just put his hand out and get the other dude to shake.
Yeah, that's right. Exactly. Yeah. That's how you eliminate it, but. Yeah, like that's like what Marshman said. It's like that could be the 20th take in their defense, but still, like, yeah, it's one of those things. Like, it's pretty shit.
I'm on your side. I'm someone who likes the movie. How is it in five minutes?
It's flipped. me and Michael defending it today.
That's the first. I'm trying to help you guys out a little bit, here, and you're actually defending it.
I started with
oh my god, this is gonna be shit. To me going, oh mate, he can't even grab a hand. But in his defense, press for time. I know the director, we had lunch last weekend, and he said that.
And like, that's another thing with the directing is that you brought it up, the main guy. Colwyn, the king, the guy who played the king, he was kind of half smiling all the time, which kind of gave me no
intensity.
Yeah, yeah. There was nothing at risk.
Nah. You know, the final fight when like you looked in his eyes and he's like, I got the glaive, bitch. It's like. Yeah. No, you should be like, fuck. Oh, am I about to die?
Right, the glaive. The fucking starfish boomerang. Like,
that no, thing, wait, wait, hold up. Be careful.
Dude, that thing
gave me a boner.
That thing was just a fucking glorified hole saw. It was just made to cut through walls.
Yeah, that's fair enough. Hey, look, I got to admit, I was pretty pissed off. That he didn't use it more, at like years.
Yeah, well,
like as a kid watching that, I was like,
"What? He got it within the first, was it 30
minutes? I don't understand why he couldn't use that. He could have fucking taken the bandits out. He could have taken the slayers out.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I think the old guy stopped him almost immediately, and he's like, "No, not here. When the time is right." And it's like, oh.
Every time is right.
Yeah, like,
I mean, goddamn.
Seriously, it's just made.
Bandits, big, like, speaking for someone who watched it as a kid, I'm like, whip that thing out and fucking kill these bitches.
The bandits.
Yeah, the ones that joined him.
That joined him.
Yeah, but I actually really liked that scene, though, where they kind of joined him. Like, the dialogue and stuff.
Yeah, but if you had the glaive, would you have thrown that shit?
No, because they didn't really perceive too much of a threat.
Oh, not later, but initially.
No, even initially, dude. Like, yeah, I think it was just the way it was acted, that it was just kind of like, yeah, these guys just want to rob them. They don't actually want to mean them any harm.
I would have killed them.
Like, I think if really one glaive, of them...
Because it's cool.
I think if one of them jumped out and, like, kicked one of them off the horse or fucking...
Yeah, but that was stabbed him to kill.
When?
The dude, the fuck, turned into a pig. They threw axes at him, not knowing what he was.
I totally forgot about that. Yeah.
Speaking of that fuckwit, most useless character ever.
Oh, yeah.
My
God.
Pretty much.
Yeah, why was he there?
Had a guy, a mage. You call him a mage?
Yeah, like, the scene he popped up was like, oh, okay, he's a comedy relief without being funny.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wouldn't even call him a mage.
Yeah, and he can turn into animals. Like, he's supposed to have... He's descended from a people that can turn into animals. But he was useless.
Like, yeah. Now I give you that.
He added nothing to it.
Absolutely nothing.
Apart from pissing me off.
Yeah.
Darling, Oliver Marsh says he was supposed to be a comic relief.
Yeah.
Yeah, and like without the second he popped up. Like,
without the comedy, though.
Yeah.
What about the princess? Like, she really didn't have too much of a role in it either, other than just being kidnapped.
Yeah.
And then when
giving him fire so he can fucking shoot flames out of his hands.
But you know what? As soon as I seen that, I'm like, that's going to be a... They're going to call back to that. Like,
yeah, and it pissed me off,
it's kind
too.
Of, it's kind of one of those things that's like, you don't show a gun without firing it.
Yeah.
Like... It's kind of frustrating.
Like, at the end when she's like, our love will fucking beat him. Like, oh, go fuck yourself.
Mm.
Please.
And then,
it's not you. It's us.
And the...
that was fucking horrible.
There was something else.
Every single character was fucking so two-dimensional. It was ridiculous.
Yeah, like, cardboard cutouts.
It was
pretty much
fucking crazy.
Yeah. It was good or horrible, but...
Like,
oh, yeah.
The king, to me especially, like, there was no substance to him whatsoever. He was just...
You know what I liked is I think it was her father. He couldn't fight for shit. No wonder he had a girl.
Well, that's it. All the feminists are going to jump on this motherfucker.
Oh, yeah, whoops.
But the old guy that was helping him throughout it all...
No, the father... Her father.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, I'm talking about the old guy.
The choreography for that sword fight, and then he's like, ah! It's like,
I think the choreography, just in general, for that film was pretty bad. Well, not even bad, it was just kind of like a testament to the fucking time.
Look at Star Wars, the original Star Wars.
Yeah.
The lightsaber battles between Obi-Wan and Darth Vader was pitiful.
If you strike me down now, I'll become more powerful than you could imagine. Yeah. He just fucking swings the thing.
But swings the fucking lightsaber. Even the swing.
Even that, yes.
It was like all rigid shit. It was like...
But not even that. Look at the fucking... Linda. Have you seen They Live? With, Roddy Piper.
I've come here to kick ass and chew bubblegum.
That fight scene between him and fucking Keith David.
That's one of the worst things ever.
One of the greatest things ever.
They Live, from a John Carpenter film. Yeah. And then Duke Nukem put it in
really?
For the games. Yeah.
When was They Live, mate? That was 80s as well.
80s. Yeah. Early
80s.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, so better do with sunglasses.
You
can.
Duke Nukem was badass and came up with that.
Well,
shit.
No, I think that Duke Nukem was made off of the main character from They Live, because Duke, like, when you look back at Duke Nukem, you look at the storyline of Duke Nukem, it's kind of like They Live, but just certain elements are taken out. Like,
right.
They Live was kind of like there's an alien race that's taken over the Earth. And they've basically made it like everyone... It's like
they can look like people.
Look like people, but right. Like everything that they do, like...
Is that actually out of a movie?
Yeah. Yeah, he walks. He walks. He's basically he's got a pair of glasses.
A lot of gum.
Yeah, he's basically got a pair of glasses that lets him see the aliens, and everything's in black and white. So then, when he looks at money, when he looks at money, it says like, "This is your god" on it, on these bits of paper.
Right.
And he takes glasses off, and it's money. And you're like, "What the fuck?" He looks at billboards, and it says like, "Procreate," and then he takes it off, and there's like a naked woman on it with a can of cola.
Right.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. Like for the that time, screams,
that actually screams procreate to me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
we know you love coke.
Yeah, that's I haven't watched that since I was like fucking six.
Yeah, really. I gotta rip your head off and shit down your neck. Does that have that in it?
I think it has elements of that. It has without the language, because I think it's PG-13.
Yeah.
No, there was no PG-13 back then, so it would have been 15.
No, he swears in it.
Yeah, but there was no PG-13 rating back then.
Yeah, I'm just saying, like he does drop fuck in the movie. So. Yeah.
In the game, he comes across a pinball machine, and it's like
I don't have time to play with myself.
Yeah.
Because
it's like a Duke Nukem pinball machine, and you walk up to it and hit the action button. It's like, I don't have time to play with myself.
Yeah, so fuck yeah, back to Krull.
Yeah.
A bit off basically track. That's how good the movie was. We started thinking of other movies.
And games.
I think
Nah, look, I always understood it's dated and that people wouldn't enjoy it. It wasn't a blockbuster, so it obviously wasn't that great for its time.
On the topic
of other media though, I reckon that could have made a good novel if it was written well enough, and like you could make a series based on like that world.
Like, well, yeah, that's like there the Dune problems. The there Dune fucking movie. Like I bought Dune the other week, and I started because I was like, I'd heard it's really, really good. It's one of those things that's like, it's one of those movies that you should watch, but it's also a set of novels.
Yeah, yeah. It was originally a set of novels.
There's a fucking fandom for it, dude. Yeah, massive like fandom. Star Trek, yeah. And I was like, all right, I'll give it a go. And I started watching it, and I think I got about 15 minutes in, and I'm like, I can't do this.
Yeah.
I'm like, this is really, really, really bad.
Mm.
And, sorry. Yeah, it was really bad. So, I just turned it off. But, yeah, I think Krull could do that. I think as a novel would be really good.
Yeah.
Well, look at, you know, who knows? Maybe it was. Maybe it was one.
No, they actually did a novel adaptation after the movie was made.
Oh, it didn't take off.
They remade that movie.
Jesus. Yeah, I tried looking for it.
2001.
And no one knew about it.
You find it?
Couldn't find anything.
Like even maybe
it was in production it never really got made.
Even me, as an old school sort of a fan of it, someone who grew up watching that. In his era.
When were you born? 79?
79. So.
So you would have been 4 years old when it came out?
Yeah,
but
you were
4 years old when it came out, but I watched it in the 80s. So it was early to late 80s when I watched it. Sorry, mid to late.
Do you remember 80s. It being big? Like, do you remember your mates talking about it?
No. That was definitely something that was watched
at home. It was a cult film, I think.
So, yeah, it was even back then.
But it was something that, like, have you ever heard of the series V?
Yeah.
Yeah. So it was like, V was big.
But
we used to talk about V, like,
V
on the way home from a school, and V was amazing. V. And that was a series.
Hmm.
Is V the alien ones though?
Yeah.
Yeah. So the only reason I've
lizards.
Yeah, the only reason I've heard about that is because they remade it like between 2000 and
I'm talking about the original 2005. So like V was something that was massive. Krull was something that wasn't.
Okay. Yeah. It so was, that'd be yeah. It'd be a cult
Krull,
film.
Krull, yeah, back it then. Was a cult film. There were.
I quickly looked at it on IMDb and. Have a guess what the budget was.
Fucking $3. What, too much?
Have a guess. Yeah, have a guess.
I don't know.
A fucking stab in the dark.
$500,000.
And what do you think?
I'd probably go with, $500,000, maybe $700,000.
$27 million.
Fuck off.
I don't know if that's inflated.
No
for now.
Way if they made that money back. No
I don't know
way.
If it's inflated for now, but 27 million.
Yeah, same here.
$27 million back then was phenomenal.
We think the biggest film, I think, that was made at that time was the Donna Superman, the first Superman, which was $75 million, and that kind of broke.
No, that was 70s. The first Superman was 70s.
Yeah, but I think even then it was like it was still the most expensive, because even then it was like three times the budget in the 70s when it was made. $75 million or something like that.
Right. How much was Carl supposed to be?
27. So that to me just kind of would be like, well, that'd be about the average then for like a big Hollywood film.
Yeah, it must have blown it all on the location.
I don't know.
Over that,
I sort of see it in things like the spider scene, because that was a big set.
Yeah,
and the animation for the spider. That would have taken
a lot. So the spider scene was a big set because they did have.
Yeah, they put all their washing on the line.
Fuck that shots. Yeah.
there was a lot of shots where it's like it looked like it was shot on location, because it had to be like an alien feel. So they've obviously shot it in big, vast valleys and mountain ranges.
Mm.
And that part where he's climbing the mountain, the king's climbing the mountain, and that looked pretty legit. Shot on. Yeah. On location, didn't look like it was a soundstage.
Yeah, same with the horses, I think.
Oh, yeah, yes. Yeah, the horses.
I mean, for sure. You'd need to be outside if you got flying horses.
Yeah.
So.
Flying horses.
Nah, but even the part when they were capturing them.
Yeah, I think that's what he's talking about. The part where these, where they're capturing.
I was joking, Dave, about the flight horses.
They're not real.
I don't get jokes.
Ah.
What?
Yeah.
Oh god, that was an amazing moment though. Carl.
We're watching. And like, there's a part where, all right, you see it from their point of view.
No, but set it up. They capture these mare horses.
All right, the fire mares. So they capture the fire mares, and
that can run 1,000 leagues in a day.
1,000 leagues in a day, and they start running, and the hooves light up, and there's fire like coming out of these hooves. And then you're watching them ride along. They're all smiling at each other because this is cool, right?
In front of
one dude standing up on one.
Yeah.
Seriously, I'd be smiling at you if I could travel 100.
Yeah. Liam Neeson.
1,000 legs in a day, I'd be cheering.
Liam Neeson's cops riding one on its own.
So then it just switches to this view, like obviously from whoever's riding. Like, from the view of the horse.
Yeah, you have a wide of them riding the horses, and then it sets up to a POV shot.
So there's all these valleys, right? And you're watching them, and it's like... You can hear the hooves. It's like... And then there's like these massive gullies. And Carl's like... Oh, what, so they can fucking fly now? Oh, the horses can fly now? next 10 seconds, it goes to this shot where there's this, like, massive canyon. And the horses go from one end of the canyon to the other. And they're flying. And they leave this fire trail all the way over this canyon. And I'm just like...
Oh fuck, wouldn't that be a key thing though to say, like, instead of just saying they're flying, they can travel 1,000 leagues in the day?
Yeah.
Why is that? Because they can fly. That's why they can travel those vast distances.
But I like it for the fact of, they never show them jumping their canyon first. They just show the view of them, like...
A fire trail.
This is like them going over these rolling hills almost. And it's like, how are they doing that? There's a flaw in this fucking angle. It's like, they fucked up. They can fly now, what? And then,
Oh, as a camp. Alright, I'm did you notice that the what were the beast minions called?
Slayers.
Did you notice that they changed from black to white when they got to the
Yeah, because obviously the elite soldiers. The elite soldiers, man. Whites are better.
No, I've got a more simple fucking explanation for that. Because it's a black castle. How are you going to fucking pick out the black things in a black castle?
Oh, come on.
That's all it boiled down to. I can guarantee it. Yeah.
From a technical perspective, then yeah. I mean...
Yeah, like, how are you going to shoot them on camera?
Yeah.
Oh, look, if they were black on camera, you'd still see them.
No. Not that well. Not that well that you can make them out.
Hey, don't be racist. It's purely a race thing.
Oh, no, that's another thing. I didn't really get the reason why... that was our fate there. We just touched. I didn't really get why the beast took the princess up until Michael said it at the end. And it was because...
I didn't even know if you picked that up.
Yeah, so, did you pick that up before
Michael Because the dude says the prophecy at the start, right? Like, to these two people will marry and they'll rule the kingdom. And they'll have a son that will rule the galaxy.
Yeah.
But the prophecy is like the queen will choose a king. And
queen of an ancient name.
Yeah, will choose a king, and their son will rule the galaxy. So it doesn't matter who the fuck she marries, as long as she chooses him, and their son will rule the galaxy. So basically, the beast wanted a son to rule the fucking galaxy.
And that's
what it was.
That made so much more sense.
Yeah, and that was actually pretty fucking cool. I like that.
Yeah, but it was like, why didn't you say that?
Yeah,
like why didn't you set that up? Like, don't.
Yeah, look, you know...
That was a little bit obscure. It was a bit of a reach, you know what I mean?
I've never looked at it from that angle.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Yeah.
That's actually a good point.
Yeah.
I've just noticed that she's hot.
This is going to happen in every fucking movie.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah, as long as there's cheeks in it.
So what? From...
I'm going to choose Brokeback Mountain. Just for you.
I am that single and that deprived right now. I'll look at both of those dudes and think, they're right.
Just curiously, though,
curiously?
Yeah, why do you like it? Tell us why you liked it so much. Apart from the nostalgia.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. Like, I watched it before. The first time I saw Kroll, like, shit looked real. Like, I remember watching Christopher Reeve's Superman back in the day.
Yeah.
And I didn't notice how fake the flying looked in that shit.
I just saw
him flying. I was like, that's pimp.
I really think that's
kind of... And I watch it now and I think, fuck.
Yeah.
That's lame.
I really think that's a kind of... I wouldn't even know. Like, I'd say that's kind of a child's perspective.
I don't mind the story of it. I think the story ultimately is what draws me into Kroll.
Yeah, the story is interesting. But, like, I think from what you're saying, like, when you're young, you believe that. I think that's kind of a child's perspective, because I kind of had those feelings when I'd watched when I watched Star Wars for the first time, when I watched Indy.
I'm just
thinking about it too now, I'm like...
Yeah, but a kid's more willing to accept something as magical.
But kids nowadays, you think about, like, my brother's 10 years younger than me, so, and he's got all these video games and stuff, that kind of, the graphics and everything, the storylines in them are so much more, they're better.
Complex.
And complex than what Kroll is.
Mm.
So he would be watching that, and it's kind of raised the bar.
Yeah.
So if he watched I think at the same age that I watched, say, Kroll, Star Wars,
Dave watched Kroll.
I think that's possibly what it is the availability of technology and the whole perception of that magic.
Hmm.
Yeah, like...
The suspension of disbelief.
As a kid, that shit, like I said, even with Superman, like that shit looked pretty decent. Like, he stuck his hand into the lava... And I have to say that was pretty cool.
Like, even watching it,
I was like, oh my fuck, he's putting his hand in, like, ah, you know. Now you look at it and it's like, that's
just orange water.
They've overlaid some fire onto his hand, and then when the fire disappears, it's like, oh, that looks like jelly. That's jelly.
Yeah, I think that's what happened with me and like a lot of people, I guess, with the Star Wars prequels. Like, the original trilogy was just magic.
Yeah.
To me, anyway, as a kid. 10 years later, you watch these fucking
monstrosities. But do you get a sense of the acting isn't as good in the prequels?
In the prequels? Of course not. It's fucking horrible.
It's terrible.
Yeah. The only saving grace is fucking Big Dick Neeson and fucking Ewan McGregor.
Yeah, I was going to say, because the acting from Ewan McGregor is actually really, I think, really on
his acting. Like, he's acting in Revenge of the Sith.
But having said that, I've seen Natalie Portman in movies.
Yeah, she's fantastic.
I think she's fantastic. Yeah. But I watch her in the Star Wars movies, and it's pitiful. I'm sorry, Natalie Portman. I know you're not listening. But your acting in the Star Wars movies was absolutely atrocious.
Honestly, I think that's the writing more than anything. Because the writing, the dialogue in those prequels.
I think that's Lucas. Can bring them
to life. I don't think that's so much the writing.
Didn't Lucas write it?
He wrote the story and the screenplay for the first one. He wrote the story for all of them, but then somebody else wrote the screenplays for the other two, which is essentially what happened with the original three and the directing.
Well, if you want to know how bad the writing is,
watch
the scene in episode 2 when him and fucking Padme are in that field on fucking Naboo. That's some all right, worst
this
fucking
is, this is, I'll probably get a fucking losers both on this, but all three of them sucked, but the second one I liked more than the other two. Attack of the Clones.
I watched it over and over again.
Don't know why.
Third one more because of the lightsaber battle between Obi-Wan and Anakin
at the end.
Mm.
I thought the choreography in that was phenomenal.
Yeah,
that was good. Epic fight. The only reason I wouldn't choose the Yoda fight over it is because that was CGI. But these two dudes were going at it with like wooden sticks for days and days and days before they had to do that.
You know what I think it really is too about those prequels is that it was so all over the place. With the originals, with each original, they had three acts and they were on three different locations.
Yeah.
In each one. But then you go to the prequels and the first one, I think they're on four different planets. Tatooine.
Naboo. Do they go to Coruscant in the first one?
Yeah, they go to Coruscant. And then I think there's something else. And then it's essentially it's repeated with the second and third one as well.
Yeah.
But the third one even more. Because they have that battle on the fucking... They have that lightsaber battle that you're talking about.
You know what else?
But the
second one as well. They go to that bug planet where fucking Dooku is.
Yeah, it's where Dooku is. Yeah, they hunt down fucking Dooku. Yeah.
The bit where Anakin / Darth finally gets told that, you know, what's her face dies.
Padme.
And he's like, no! it's like, oh, come on.
Every time I hear that,
was so cliche.
The first time.
Think about the fact that James Earl Jones had to look at the script and fucking do that.
Yeah. No! I died a little bit.
Anyway, Kroll.
Oh yeah, fuck, got sidetracked there.
Yeah,
back to Kroll. Yes. All right. Well, Dave, you liked it for the nostalgia, pretty much, right? Like that reminded you of your childhood.
Oh yeah.
Is that Michael? What are you?
I mean, I tried to like it. There were parts of it I liked. Like I said, I think it'll work better as a novel than a movie. A novel series, even. I would read probably multiple stories.
Thumbs up or thumbs down?
Fucking.
Or as fucking Joe says in Mad Max, mediocre.
I'd give it a fucking half a thumbs up.
Look,
I got something out of it.
Yeah,
I definitely got something out of it.
Yeah, I got a podcast out of it. Fucking about it.
So thumbs down.
For the record, I also want to say the Beast looks like something from a Tool music video.
Yeah,
really does.
Oh, look, I had a lot of problems with the aspect ratios of the Beast.
Yeah, he did change size a lot, didn't he?
Compared to I still
have to have massive respect for people who can shoot on film and then do that shit.
Yeah.
Like superimpose things on the screen that are much like they've shot it and then they make it look much larger. Like, because you think about it, there was no digital effects back then. Yeah. It was all shot on film.
And that's a whole thing in itself, yeah. Is the fact that that thing was done in what, pre-80?
83.
So it was done 83.
Yeah.
And like the effects that they had on hand,
yeah,
for those times.
Yeah, like there's no way in hell I'd be able to do that now. Like, or any, I don't think any one of us would be able to do that unless we had a fucking computer. Yeah. At our fingertips, but yeah.
Thank fuck for Tron.
The Tron?
Yeah.
What, the Tron set the standard?
Yeah, it started computer effects. Digital effects.
Didn't Star Wars do that? Didn't Lucas kind of pioneer it?
Yeah, but Tron sort of took it to a new level. Because like 90% of Tron.
Wasn't it Sphere?
No.
Wasn't Sphere up there?
Wait. Oh, that just gave me a new movie.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, but don't say it now.
I'm not going to.
Yeah.
But like 90% of Tron was
there's a movie effects. That I watched as
probably
a kid.
99% of
Tron. What was Tron made?
Like 80 something? Later on. Late 80s, I think.
Yeah, well, cause I think Sphere was made in the late 70s. No, it wasn't, because that had...
Sphere? What's Sphere?
You guys keep going.
No, Sphere, I think Sphere kind of utilised CGI in a way that movies hadn't done it before.
Yeah.
And they were like, this is actually really, really fucking good. You kind of had that. It really suspended disbelief. And pretty much, I think Sphere was the standard. What, and they were like, we could make fucking T2. What?
Tron was 1982.
There you go. 1982. So it wasn't that fucking groundbreaking.
That was before fucking Croft.
I'm telling you, dude. I really think it was Lucas and Star Wars. I think you're all right in the sense that Tron was probably the first movie to utilize it in that such a big way in the film. What's that? 1998 Sphere, yeah. But yeah, so I was like, I'm sure there's something else that I'm like, it was kind of the first movie that they were like, oh, fucking, we can use CGI and visual effects in a lot bigger and badder way.
Yeah, what about Tron?
No, because it wasn't such a groundbreaking film.
Tron?
No, not Tron. Like this other movie. But, yeah. I haven't watched the original Tron in a long time.
I've watched it semi-recently. And by that, I mean, I think like 2 years ago.
So, fucking...
I fucking love that movie, man. It's so good.
Oh, Carl. I won't be able to sit through that again, dude.
No. There's however, no like, good. Days back. But
sit through what?
Carl.
Oh, I'm not asking you to.
Oh, no. I'm just saying in general.
However, if they did do a remake, I would probably watch it. I'd be interested.
I watched the second one.
There's a second one?
Apparently so.
There's the remake. Yeah, the 2000.
But there's another movie.
I don't think it ever got to production.
You're just talking about computer, like pioneering computer. CGI.
Yeah.
What movie were we talking about?
Yeah, well, we were talking Michael about was Tron. Talking about Tron.
Tron, when did that come out?
82.
Right, okay. This one's 84. That'll be my next pick.
Yeah. Oh, you know, that's what God, also,
that's going to fucking kill me for the next 2 weeks now. I'm going to look at every movie released in 1984.
That's a bit not be Blade Runner.
It's another nostalgia one. Oh, I think it's a little bit better than Crawl.
It's not Blade Runner.
No.
Blade Runner was...
I can't sit through Blade Runner, please. Ooh, don't.
Blade Runner was in 84.
Is that...
Was it 8?
It was like a little after Alien.
I think it was before, wasn't it?
No, Blade Runner was after Alien.
Who directed...
You guys won't like this one.
Who directed Blade Runner? It was Ridley Scott. I'm pretty sure it was before Alien.
Because Alien was Ridley Scott's like big fucking...
Yeah, and I think... I remember watching Blade Runner and being like... Oh, I can see the influence of Alien there.
David, shut up. The adults are talking.
What?
We're talking about better movies than Crawl, Dave.
So am I.
What are you talking about?
I the next movie.
Blade Runner was 1982.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure Alien was 1979.
Blade Runner?
Blade Runner was 1982.
Oh, fuck. And Alien was 1979?
I'm pretty sure it was. Considering it's one of my favourite movies, I should fucking know that. Yes, 1979. Go fuck yourself, Carl.
No, because I was sure. I was sure Blade Runner was before it. Because I remember watching Blade Runner and those same shots in Alien.
The original Superman.
Well, he could have just done it for Blade Runner.
This is what I didn't get. It looked so much more advanced in Alien than it did in Blade Runner. Watching Blade Runner, I was like, you can tell this is a fucking 80s film. Watching Alien, I was like, I don't really know what year this was made.
Yeah.
Like, there's movies that you can watch. Like, watching Crawl, I was like, yeah, this is a fucking 80s film.
Oh, no, Alien is in a fucking league of its own.
That's what I mean. Like, watching... Like, how the fuck do you... How do you go from that in 4 years, where technology seemingly should have advanced, where you shoot Alien and it looks great, like it set a fucking standard, and then you shoot fucking Blade Runner and you're like, that's a miniature. Well, I can tell that's a miniature.
To be fair, that's just like differing opinions, because I think Blade Runner still looks fucking amazing.
Think it looks amazing?
Yeah, I still think it does.
I watch it and I can see that looks
really.
Yeah, I always like the way they did that
Alien. I was going to call it the black sheep of the fucking series, but that's more fucking Alien 4, right?
So. Resurrection. Yeah.
Resurrection.
But Resurrection does have Ron Perlman.
Yeah, and whenever...
The way the third Alien moved and the way they...
More like a dog.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I did like that.
Yeah.
And it's got Bill Paxton.
Yeah.
Oh!
Game over, man!
Game over!
And he's not in 3.
Yeah, he is.
Well, he's dead.
Yeah, well, you have that flashback of him.
Oh, is it 2?
Yeah, he's in 2.
Yeah. Game over, man! Game over!
What are we gonna do now? Did you like 2 better than 1?
No, I like 1 better than 2.
Yeah.
Because, to me, Alien is a fucking horror movie, and it's a good fucking sci-fi horror movie. Aliens is an action movie, and you can tell just by looking at the directors. You got fucking Ridley Scott to do the first one, and James Cameron did the second. I mean, I'm not going to fucking deny what Cameron did for the series. He did amazing things.
Even the third one. The third one was shot by fucking.
Who did the third one?
It was another big director.
Yeah,
big action director.
So there's 3 different directors for him.
Yeah, but they
I always thought they were all Ridley Scott.
It was Scott, Cameron, and then...
For some odd reason, I'm thinking fucking Roman Polanski.
It wasn't Polanski.
I actually thought they were all Ridley Scott. That's horrific. Who did the fourth one then?
It was another pretty well-known director. Carpenter?
Yeah, they all have different movies.
Prometheus was Ridley Scott.
And he's going to be shooting
Fincher.
The next one.
Fincher did
that's
3.
It. Yeah.
Fucking mindfuck Fincher.
Who's the fourth one? Because even the fourth one, I think, was a pretty well known director.
Yeah, I want to say Carpenter or Craven.
I think it was Carpenter.
Resurrection.
But then in saying that, it's not really Carpenter's style. Like, he seems to be more in control director.
Alien 3, 59% on Metacritic.
Oof.
Well, that's pretty brutal.
Breeze.
Yeah.
Ah, oh, that's right. It was fucking Frenchy. Jean-Pierre Jeunet. What the fuck? He did something else that I
know the name.
Yeah. I've seen other stuff of his. Emily. Fucking love that movie.
Emily?
Yeah.
He did the fourth
Alien movie. Yeah.
So just to go back.
Yeah, Emily, I've seen once. That was a good movie.
Fucking go back to Kroll. reminded me of Conan.
Yeah, it does have Conan sort of.
Very Conan elements in it.
Yeah,
especially that voiceover, that voiceover part, like
at the start.
Start and the finish, but all, it's because that voiceover is that old dude that kind of helps him along the way. That's kind of like in Conan, where that voiceover, the way that old guy delivers his lines is like the voiceover in Conan. and the way pretty much everything's delivered in Conan, very fucking abrupt, in like, and kind of an exclamation point.
Hmm.
I picture an exclamation point at, like, when reading his dialogue, just everything is yelled. Did you get that?
No.
What, the old dude? Everything was so fucking forceful that he said.
It was very theatrical.
Yeah.
I'd say.
For me, it's not so much exclamation.
Speaking of voiceover, one thing that bugged me at the start of that movie is when the fucking princess is talking to her dad, and they're talking about, like, what the fuck's going on, and they're just cutting away to people riding on horses while they're talking. That fucking shit me.
Yeah.
Like, stay in the scene.
Because it was, like, 3 minutes, but you know what I think that was? I think that was a matter of...
That could have been ADR for all I fucking know.
I think it was, because when that first...
Oh, the audio seemed a bit off, didn't
it? Yeah, but that was more than just watching it than what you said. Like, the audio's out a little bit. Right. Because she had quite a bit of dialogue, and her mouth didn't move very much.
Hmm.
I think they didn't get the footage that they wanted.
Yeah.
So, I think that's why they cut to that. Because he had about 3 minutes of people riding on horses. And then just dialogue over the top of it.
Fucking weird, man.
It was like, all right, I get it.
Yeah,
like,
yeah, they're people and they're horses.
Yeah. The horse, these ones don't fly.
Yeah.
And everything, one thing I didn't really like too much about it is that everything was so bright. Like, I liked the lighting. The lighting I thought was good, but when put into context with the planet, I'm like, I don't know. Everything just seems so bright. And when you associate bright blue skies...
The planet has two suns.
Yeah. What's that remind you of, kids? Fucking Star Wars. Star Wars, Conan, Neverending Story. What was the other one?
I still say that first shot reminds me of Star Wars more than fucking Alien.
I think it reminds me of Alien. I think it's just the space part.
Well, you look at the first shot of Star Wars, it's the fucking Star Destroyer coming from the top of the thing. And it goes for fucking ever. Yeah. The spaceship is coming from the side and it goes for fucking ever.
Who said Neverending Story at 2 seconds?
Me. No, just that the movie Krull reminds me of all those movies.
Yeah.
Yeah. Neverending Story, Star Wars, Alien, Conan, and what was the other one?
Shit. To be fair, I'm going to throw a new one in there. I've got a bit of a Clash of the Titans vibe in there.
The old Clash of the Titans?
Yeah, the old Clash of the Titans.
Man. Is that just because of the Cyclops, though?
No. It's because of the adventure. Because, like...
What's his name?
Perseus made so many fucking pit stops along the goddamn way.
Yeah.
They do it in this movie as well.
Mm. Alright, so overall... I didn't like it. But that's the point of it. To watch movies we haven't watched before. Or to watch movies that we love. Evidently, this is not one of them for me. But, Dave, you...
Oh, look, it's not my go-to movie.
Yeah.
It's obviously, I said, it's a nostalgia movie. I'll watch it when
But you like it, that's the point.
Fucking bored out of my mind. And there's nothing else that I feel like watching. I'll throw it on. I'm not going to say I don't like it.
Yeah, you like it. Yeah, there's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
Michael?
I didn't hate it.
Yeah.
I think I tolerated it.
Alright, there you go. Michael tolerated it. I didn't like it. And Dave reminds you of when he had no pubes. So.
It really does.
Next. Are we going to make this a weekly thing?
Can we
make it a weekly thing? Do you reckon we should make
just
it
quickly,
a.
Quickly. Yeah. It's warm in this bitch. And there's a really nice breeze coming through that door.
Yeah, fantastic. So do you want to make this a weekly thing or like a...
Whatever.
A two-weekly thing?
I'm good.
Every 2 weeks or every week? We can discuss this off the podcast, I suppose.
Yeah, I'm just cutting this out.
I think...
people aren't waiting on bated breath.
Yeah.
Put it on.
Well, I think something we leave in the podcast is who's doing the next movie.
Yeah, that's what I'm going to get to.
All right, so who's next?
So that's what I'm building up to.
Who wants to be next?
Wait. Why don't we let Dave choose?
Yeah, you know what? Yeah, no. That's a good point. Whoever chose this week can decide who's picking the next week.
Nah, because then it's just going to alternate.
No. You choose this one time, and that'll be the order from now on.
Yeah, we can just that's how we're going to alternate then.
So, would you rather see a movie of my choosing next week or Carl's choosing?
Oh, I fucking already know which one he's going to pick.
What, yeah, me?
He's going to flip.
No. The truck is Carl. Sorry, I'm picking up some coasters. One has a truck.
Do you want me to just grab a coin from
one? One has a car. No, no.
Well, why have you got two?
Because that's you. That's Marshman.
Yeah.
You guys are going to choose.
No, that defeats the point of fucking us choosing.
Well, it's still random.
Well, then you just pull one out.
All right. So whichever one I place on the table,
yeah,
is going to be whoever.
Well, is, you know who it's going to be, though, right?
Not really. No.
Then how are we going to know the difference?
I think he's too drunk. Well, you said the truck's me and truck's the blue part's you.
And the ute's you.
Ah, okay.
So yeah, the car's you, the truck's Carl.
Okay. I didn't realize the coasters were different.
Wait,
I thought they were
all fucking same. Wait, why am I the truck?
Because you're bigger.
Because you're a truck. Oh,
fuck you.
All right, here he goes.
That's blue. All right.
I don't know who it is.
All right, turn it over.
Someone turn it over.
You turn it over.
It's the truck.
It's you.
All right, yeah.
You
do. That's right. So, all right.
Good. It actually gives me a little more time to get my movie.
Okay. All right. Well, next week I'll be choosing the movie.
That put me in a real spot. I'm glad I thought of that.
All right. Next week I'll be choosing the movie, and it looks like the rotation will be Dave, me, and then Michael. So, until next week, it gives me a week to think about what I'm going to choose. Anyway.
Well, considering I think this whole thing was your idea initially. You should have fucking had massive amounts of time to think of something. Figure out. Get on it.
Well, then, from Dave. All right, so that's it. That's it for the week. Until next week.
That's a good sign off, too.
So,
pull your finger out and get on with it.
There you go, that's it. All right, until next week. Pull your finger out and get on with it.